Hello everybody, I'm very glad to be here today. It's always a pleasure to be at my data conference and of course in Helsinki. So today, unfortunately, I've got a lot of questions and I hope you've got the answers. So the first question is, can my data be a public policy? So how could public authorities get involved in this my data ideas? So this slide is, what is a public policy? A public policy is what government decide to do or not to do. This means that we have to decide it, and we have to decide it on two points. The first is opportunity, which value will it bring for the citizens, for the society as a whole, and should we intervene as a public actor or not, and feasibility, can we really do something about this point? So I can take an example. For example, swimming is in fact a public policy because every government in Europe considers that everyone should know how to swim. So I hope everybody can swim here. This means that the public authority decide that you should learn how to swim at school. And public authority and the cities are building swimming pools. So they think that there is some value to know how to swim. And they think that we've got levers to help people to learn how to swim. So it's quite the same with my data. So this could be a public policy if it can bring value for the citizen and the society, if we can help for it, and if we can find the levers to make it concrete, and of course, if we decide so. So first of all, what could be the values for a public point of view? When I'm a speaker in conferences, most of the time I begin my speeches by saying, I'm very sorry about it, but we are liars. We've been lying for a long time because we've been saying that we put every citizen in the center of our public policy. But this is really the truth, because we're building silos and everybody's doing the same. And maybe for the first time with my data, we've got the opportunity to put really the citizen at the center of the information and of the public policies. Getting data from the operators, having new services, and bringing also values for other citizens. The other value is, of course, empowerment, because by giving more information, more data to the citizen, it can bring new way of acting, a new way of being a citizen, because the difference between a resident and a citizen is the citizen understands how he lives in the city and what can he do to change it. How can be a part of the change of a society? Of course, there is a value, an economic development value, because with my data, we can imagine we have to create new services, new companies, new jobs, new economical development. So this is value for a city. Of course, there is the subject of trust, because there is a problem of trust between citizens and public authorities. And my data could be a possibility to create more trust. This could also help to change behavior, because with my data, for example, I think there is a topic tomorrow concerning energy. With my data, we can help people to have a better behavior on energy, but it could be also on mobility, on health. So it can help to produce better public policies. This is why I call it from empowerment to public policies co-production. But is it really useful? Do you, as my data organization, really need public authorities to help for it? What are the difficulties? What are the problems at the moment? We had a my data project in Lyon, and we had quite a lot of problems with this project. The first one is digital operators do not want to give the data. Of course, GDPR will help for it, but it still remains very difficult to get the data from the companies. The second problem is that it's very hard to understand. We would like that everybody could really understand what is my data, and every citizen can take that data and create new services, but it's very difficult for any citizen to understand what it is about. The third problem is it's difficult to mobilize ecosystem to create new services. So there is quite a threshold effect. I'm sure that my data will work when we will have a lot of data, a lot of people using it, and a lot of services. then this will work. But this is not the state at the moment. So how can we do, what do we have to do to get more people to understand how it works, to get more data, and to get more services? So these are the difficulties. On the other point, what could be the levers in the hand of the public authorities? The first one is regulation. GDPR is an example, but it is only an example. We could invent new regulation, new laws, to help this happen. The second one is public sector, public authorities has got a lot of data. So we've got the possibility to help by giving more and more data to the citizen. Then, of course, economic development and innovation are public policies. So cities can help to create economical value to animate in the territory startups to help the creation of value. And of course, in our goal, we have to help people to change in the digital life. So it's one of our jobs. Of course, we consider in Lyon that data should be a public policy. And we made a very big decision maybe 3 years ago, deciding that digital is a public policy. And concerning data, it should be a public policy to provide governance, to facilitate production and circulation of data, which is free flow of data in the territory. We should provide skills, methods, and tools to help for it, value data for every kind of data, including personal data, and think large, not only in the city, but how can we network it with other cities, with other countries in Europe. So, how should we drive this public policy? If we decide, we say, for the city, for the countries, for the Europe, this is a very important thing. How do we do this? This is the first very important question. Because it can be bottom-up, and this is what we are doing at the moment. We are making experiments in some cities in Europe to try if it works. But what I think is, if we only on this way, when I come back in my data 2028, in 10 years, we will only move a few steps. So if you want to go faster, the idea is maybe we need another possibility, which would be rather a top-down. So will it be possible to get a kind of a European roadmap explaining how can we make the change possible with the help of the cities, and the countries, and the EU, to change really the things with my data. And we think that Europe is a good level. It's a good level because it's quite a lot of people, and there is really a lot of people in Europe thinking that personal data is very important, much more than in Asia or in the US. So, last year, when I came here, I talked about the Urban Agenda, which was very new last year. It's partnerships with about maybe 12 or 15 cities in different countries in Europe. And this partnership was created after the Amsterdam Pact. And the idea is to create an action plan and to find a solution on these different problems we can face. And there is one subject, which is dedicated on digital transition. And when I was here last year, I said that we would try to include my data as one of the actions of this action plan. So the good news is that my data is one of the actions of the partnership action plan. But for the moment, it's only an idea. This means that we think it could be a solution, but we just do not know how we could handle it. So, what could be the scenario? How could we involve the cities, the countries, and the EU in this idea, in this project? Do we want to help societal change? Is the problem, the biggest problem, people itself? The way people cannot understand what it is about? Do we want first to accelerate the free flow of data? Is the problem we do not have enough data to make it work? Or is the problem of innovation and we are looking for a killer application? So there are different routes. So what would be the best route to use? And in the partnerships, of course, we've got three different angles. The first one is better regulation. This means that we've got the question for the EU. They ask us, if we want to change the law, if we've got some ideas about it, don't hesitate. Give us the idea so that we can change the law, make better regulation to help in your project. The second point is better funding. Can we imagine a new way of funding, of getting money from the EU for projects than the one that exists at the moment to make it successful? And better knowledge, how can we share all of this information across the different countries? So these are the questions, and today is a kind of a kickoff meeting of how can we build it together? Which country, which cities would be interesting in this thinking, and how can we work together to make a proposal for the EU of this kind of a roadmap? So how can we build it together? Thank you.